TVS created quite the buzz when they unveiled their Ntorq 125cc scooter in the market, and I am here today at their Hosur facility to review it, so do stay glued to your screen as I bring you everything there is to know about the new TVS Ntorq 125. So you may wonder what is so great about the new Ntorq 125 from the stable of TVS. Well, for starters, there are a lot of first and segment features, and it has quite a different design language, which comes as a fresh change when compared to other offerings in this segment. Well, to start things off, let me talk a little bit about the design. The front is pretty aggressive and edgy looking. However, this headlamp cluster does look a little bit dated, but it blends in pretty well with the overall scheme of things. The daytime LED running light has a batwing inspired design. So TVS has used the design language found on fighter jets and has used that as inspiration to design the Ntorq 125. In fact, you have this carbon fiber finish right here on the handlebar, and over here right in front of the seat. You also have it on the panels on the sides. You also have this signature T-Rare LED lamp. You have a sporty and stubby muffler, and that actually has a really grunty exhaust note. You get a unique 3D Ntorq logo on the sides of the scooter and split sporty looking grab rails. And the instrument cluster has been inspired by the design of a gaming console. You also get large 12-inch diamond cut alloys both in the front and the rear. And you also get this jet styled afterburner setup in the rear. The overall design scheme is aggressive, it looks quite edgy, and definitely comes into the segment as a breath of fresh air. So the Ntorq 125 comes with a BS4 compliant 4-stroke single cylinder air-cooled engine. The displacement of this engine is 124.79cc, and the maximum power output is 9.4 PS at 7500 rpm and 10.5 Nm at 5500 rpm. The scooter has been built on a highly rigid underbone rectangular tube type frame. The wheelbase is stretched at 1285 mm, while the ground clearance of the scooter measures in at 155 mm. That's pretty decent considering Indian road conditions. The curb weight of the Ntorq 125 stands at 116.1 kg.
So from the perspective of a 125cc single cylinder air-cooled scooter, the performance of this TVS Ntorq is pretty thrilling. In fact, the scooter picks up speed pretty quickly and it pulls neatly all the way up to 85 kmph. Post 85 kmph, it's a bit of a struggle to get to 95. The top speed of the Ntorq 125 has been mapped at approximately 95 kmph, and it can go from 0 to 60 in approximately 9 seconds.
The scooter rides on a telescopic fork suspension in the front and a gas-filled hydraulic type coil spring shock absorber in the rear. The tyres are 100x80R12 in the front and 110x80R12 in the rear. Pretty fat and solid chunky tyres which grip the road quite well. They look and complement the overall design of the scooter as well to give it a unique look. Braking on the TVS Ntorq 125 is facilitated by 220mm discs in the front that comes with a single pot caliper. This is a pedal disc brake, and in the rear you have a 130mm drum brake setup.
The tires grip the road surface really well, so even if you're hugging in a corner or you're braking hard on the tarmac, the tires grip the road pretty well and stop without a fuss. The suspension is mildly on the rigid side. It bubbles up most undulations and bumps pretty well, and I would say that rider comfort is also enhanced with the soft foam seats, which according to me are definitely the best in the segment. Braking inspires confidence even when you're pushing the scooter hard. If you're in excess of 85 kmph and you want to come down to a halt or bring it down to about 20 or 10 kmph, it does so pretty neatly. In fact, I would say that braking performance has definitely surpassed my expectations.
So I just downloaded the TVS Ntorq app from Google Play Store, and it's about a 28 MB app, and it says three simple steps to pair. Let's take a look. So I need to press mode for 5 seconds. There it's come up. TVS 3865 BT pair mode, that's Bluetooth pair mode. Now I need to long press this icon on the phone and click OK. All right. So as you can see right now, it's searching for the scooter and it's found it, the TVS 3865. So now that my phone is connected to this, I can see the signal strength and battery strength of my mobile phone. In case I want to locate, I have to enable GPS on my phone, and through Map My India I am able to set up the park location of my scooter. So that is the last park location has been set up on the app. So now in case I need to find the location of the vehicle, I just click on the last park button and the location of the vehicle will show up. So I'm just going to set up the navigation assist and search for the airport. That's the international airport in Bangalore. It's about 71 kilometers from here. 1 hour 51 minutes of travel is what it's showing on the map. Start navigation. Now navigation assist is working on my phone. It is currently calculating the route, and as you can see over here, the icon for navigation assist has also come up and it's displaying the turns that I need to take. So it was just displaying 200 meters turn left after 200 meters. So that's pretty handy to have and definitely will assist you on your journeys. So I can also set up a do not disturb mode while I'm riding. So when the do not disturb mode is on, the scooter will block all calls and SMSs. There is also an auto reply SMS that can be generated, so I can edit it right here. Right now it says I'm driving, please call me later, but I can edit it and change it if I want to a custom message. We also have an auto sync clock which has synced the time. There is also an overspeed alert system, so I can set that. It goes up to about 120 kmph, but I don't think the scooter will go there. You can also save the last travel route when connected. You also get electric start as well as kick start. You also have an engine kill switch, so that's pretty handy to have. And a pass-by switch has also been added as a comfort and convenience feature. The TVS Ntorq 125 also comes with three trip meters, trip A and trip B, and there's a trip F for only when you are riding your scooter on reserve. You also have a low fuel indicator. So if you turn the key towards the right, it opens up 22 liters of under seat storage. That's pretty roomy and good enough to store a large full-size helmet. You also have a light inside in case you want to access the under seat storage at night. And you also get a USB charging port, which however comes with a warning that you should not charge it when the engine is off. Now the same key, if I turn it towards the left, the fuel filler cap pops open. Also on offer is a luggage hook right here. TVS has also added a dual side lock, that is a dual side steering lock. So this is locked towards the left and this is locked towards the right. Also on offer is a parking brake right here. TVS has also added an engine temperature indicator on the Ntorq 125. You also get multiple display modes, that is street and sport, along with ride stats. So the ride stats that are being offered on the Ntorq 125 are best lap and last lap. The ex-showroom price in Delhi of the Ntorq 125 is 58,750. That's a pretty competitive offering considering all the features that have been added on the TVS Ntorq 125.
If you are looking for a scooter in the 125cc segment, then the Ntorq 125 is definitely the way to go. It's got a boatload of features and some unique styling, and it comes in at a very lucrative price point. The performance of the Ntorq 125 is also pretty exceptional, and the scooter fares well on this test track that we have been pushing it on.
We hope you liked this review. If you did, please remember to like, share and subscribe to the Motown India channel. Thanks for watching and do stay tuned for all the latest action from the automotive industry in India.